The curling competition has now moved on to the mixed doubles format. Different nations come together in a male-female team where the main test is one of accuracy. The pair with the last stone in each end also has the advantage of positioning two stones on the ice before play begins, and each team delivers five stones in total. On the ice with red stones for this session was Ji Young Lee of the Republic of Korea, who was paired with Johan Nygren of Sweden. And they were up against Ben Smith of New Zealand and Cora Farrell of the USA. The Swedish and Korean partnership seemed to be working well. They stormed ahead, scoring in every end, and going into the sixth, and as it turned out, final end, they were 8 points in front. A single from the other pair meant it ended 8 points to one.
I love to have this extra curling experience besides the mixed team event. I love that they give the curlers another chance to medal at the Youth Olympic Games.
Well, I like that it gets a bit more like attacking style of play with a lot of rocks in the house.
In the match between Switzerland and Brazil and China and Norway, the scoreline was similar. Laura Engler had won bronze with Switzerland in the mixed team event. But aside from 1 point in the opening end, it would be her last score for this competition. The Norwegian and Chinese combination was in great form. They scored 4 points in the third end and never let up. The team using yellow stones completed their 9-1 victory.
I enjoyed it very much. It was a great experience here with all those people, with my team.
Really enjoyed it. It was a really great experience. It was a really great opportunity for me to learn more about curling and get better. And I definitely feel like I did. And I really enjoyed it coming here. And I'll always remember.
She don't speak so much English, so communication I thought was going to be a little problem for us, but on the field we were able to communicate great.
The pairing of Kosuke Aita from Japan and Nadezhda Karolina from Russia looked to be under pressure when their opponents from the Czech Republic and Turkey scored two in the first end. But soon they found their rhythm, read the ice well, and the yellow stones began to populate the house in every end. They soared to an 8-2 win.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I felt a little bit awkward in the beginning, but at the end I developed a good relationship with her, and it was very nice.
I'm proud to be here to represent Turkey. My partner is from the Czech Republic. Unfortunately, we lost, but it was a good experience for me.
In the final match of the session, the pattern was remarkably similar to the other games. The Canadian-Estonian team put a single point on the board to begin the match. But the pairing of Stefania Constantini of Italy and Callum Kinnear from Great Britain shut them down from then on. Twos and ones littered the scoreboard right through to the seventh end, and it finished 9 points to one.
It was really good fun. It's the first proper time I've played mixed doubles in a competition. It was good to get a first win and get through to the next round.
So far it's been pretty cool. Getting to represent Canada has been amazing and it feels pretty awesome, yeah.
So the teams through to the last 16 of the mixed doubles are Italy, Great Britain, Russia, Japan, China, Norway, and Korea, Sweden.